Welcome to another unit in this course on economics. This time I'm going to talk about the so-called Mandel-Fleming model. In the Mandel-Fleming model, I have a Keynesian perspective model combining equilibrium in the goods market, on the money market, and the foreign exchange market. So it's basically just a summary of the IS curve, the LM curve, and the ZZ, or balance of payments foreign exchange curve. If I illustrate this graphically, it will look like this. I have my goods market as represented, or my equilibrium on the goods market as represented by the IS curve. I have my money market, the equilibrium on the money market, represented by the LM curve with the different parts. And I have my foreign exchange market represented by its equilibrium via the ZZ, or balance of payments curve. And well, I have actually three possible situations in this context. Either I have the ideal situation, as is the case in this context, where all three curves actually meet in one point. So we have a general economic equilibrium. That's actually a stable situation. However, this not necessarily has to be the case. It can be that, especially in a short-term context, after some positive or negative shocks, we get one of two situations. Meaning, we have a domestic equilibrium, which is not a foreign exchange equilibrium. So it's not a global equilibrium as well. And this domestic equilibrium can either lie below the ZZ curve or above it. So in this situation, we have the equilibrium below the ZZ curve. Next slide, we will see it above. In either case, this is not stable in the long term, because what will happen is that we get, due to the differences in exchange rates, a process started which leads to us achieving either of these two possible equilibria. Which of those two will actually establish itself depends on whether we have a flexible or a fixed exchange rate regime. Because this motivates whether we will have a demand effect or a money effect. So whether the central bank acts on the development or not. In this case, we can recall we always get a money effect if we have a fixed exchange rate regime. And we always get a demand effect, so a shift in the IS curve, if we have a flexible exchange rate regime. So with a flexible exchange rate regime, we will get this equilibrium in the long term. With a fixed exchange rate regime, we'll get this equilibrium in the long term. And as I said, the situation can occur with the domestic equilibrium being below, but it can also result with the equilibrium lying above the ZZ curve. Again, this domestic equilibrium is not a long-term equilibrium. There will again be effects, either demand-side effects or money market effects. And again, as before, depending on the exchange rate regime, one of those two equilibria will be realized. If we have a flexible exchange rate regime, we will end up in this equilibrium. There will be a shift in the IS curve. If we have a fixed exchange rate regime, we will end up in this equilibrium. There will be a shift in the LM curve. And well, that's basically everything there is on the basic idea behind the Mandel-Fleming model. So I hope you enjoyed this short session. I say goodbye and see you next time.